YouTubers, well, yeah, I was doing the 4-inch holes on this, and it broke off. It had, you know, pretty good chatter going on. I wasn't trying to bury it, of course, you've seen in my videos, but that's where it went off on, and these are the screens that we're going to go over the holes. Now, I got two of them cut, and I wished I would have done the way Charles told me to do it, you know, do it halfway and then flip it over and do it, but cutting corners, you know. So the last two holes, I'll be doing that too. This one I can take my Dremel to and clean it up pretty good. But that goes over it, and that's what protects the stator from snow and ice and gives it, you know, air to breathe, you know. So I've got that ready, just got to drill out the holes on this plate also, and then I redid my markings, and I still haven't gotten that hole cut out yet, working on that. So I was thinking, you know what, I went ahead and I cut this out with my jigsaw. I used I think it was a 32 TPI bit for my jigsaw. It took a little while, you know. I'll show that on the quarter inch. I'm not waiting around for people to get this done. I've got to get this finishing up before the snow flies. They've already got the tower pretty much. I guess from what I understand, they're going to be expecting it, put it that way, period. So I got to try to weld this back in place and then go at it again, and hopefully it'll hold. And if not, then I'm going to a better type of hole cutting piece. This is it should have lasted. I've had these for years, and the ones I have, but this one just had too much chatter. You can see the teeth, they're all good. All the teeth are good yet. So I wasn't revving on it. So, all right. This is Billy, and a little slow down, but we'll be back at it here shortly. All right.
Thanks. Hey, YouTubers, Billy here. I want to show you that I got the torque tube ready, almost. I'm not waiting around no more for people. I ask them for favors, and I don't know. You know how it goes. It's just tough to get people to go along with anything. But so I went ahead and I cut this out. I got one of those metal blades, a Bosch blade, and I cut that out for the circle of this stator protector. Also the 4-inch holes. I went out and bought me a new hole saw, and it worked real good. So I did it all by hand, people, all of this. So I know my hands have been on this, not no immigrant or person from another country or somebody that's doing hard labor in another country, you know, but got the end cap. I put tape on this to protect the bearing so it doesn't get no dust or whatnot. Now what I gotta do now is with this, I gotta weld these nuts on. And what I'm going to use is this nozzle gel on the thread, so it keeps the spatter from collecting on that. Okay. So once that's done, it'll all be welded up on the inside. And then on top of this, it's going to cost me for two pipe or pieces like this. The guy is ridiculous. I don't even want to talk about it. I thought he would be able to do it since I've known him for a couple of years and he's got this business, but he wants money like everybody else. I told him I'd build him one of these and he laughed at me. So anyways, I got to get this all cleaned up. I'm going to take a wire wheel to it. Seems to work pretty good. And then I'm going to take some of that Rust-Oleum on the inside primer and then Rust-Oleum paint it. And then on the inside, and then we'll proceed to weld. Let's move this out of the way here. Okay, so now that I got that all cleaned up and ready for welding, then I got these. Okay, and we're gonna weld each one of these nuts on the inside. And this right here, this facing me, is the front of the turbine. Okay. This is the back, and this is where the 1-inch shaft will be coming through there. Okay. And that's what she looks like. I like that. That it's got, you know, it's getting there. It's getting there. It's getting pretty close to where I want to be on this. But just to give you a look-see, damn light. Let's see if I can. If you can look at my chicken drawing, you can see how I'm going to make a bracket to hold this pipe. And that's the way it's going to be set up, so that the rain and snow will run off of that. And then I'll weld it up to a 3-inch pipe. And then I got a bearing idea I was thinking of doing, but we'll see. We'll see. And then I got to get my furling mechanism with the tail on it. Yep. That's my next build too. Plus I got the two hubs that I got. That's a side view of it. This is the front. That's the back. Okay. This is where my hub and the stator will be. Okay. And let's see. Here's my... I went and I got these. They're a lot better. Comes with a great arbor. Good, strong, hardened arbor. And that's for the hubs, the 3-inch hole. It'd be three of them, not four like I got on here. Okay. And one more thing before I go. Just want to kind of show you. I've already got those are 7/16 holes. And I already got those cut out. And just kind of give you an idea, but there'll be a pretty good spacing to it. Here, I'm going to put this down for a second. Be a pretty good spacing in between the stator. It'd be like, probably like that on the other side though. Remember, this is the front side where the blades are going to go. But, give you a look-see right there. Kind of, you can see how that is going to protect that stator. All right, well, moving right along, people. Not much else going on. So that's some bullshit from some people, and you know, I don't want to even mention them. I'm really sick of them. But yeah, there you go. This is the start torque tube. Next time you'll see it, it'll be all welded up. And then we'll start on those 13-inch hubs where the magnets are going to be. I already got some of it already drawn up. My CAD cardboard paper deal that I always draw on. Okay, later.